Hey guys, the reason I haven't posted in a while is because I'm here on vacation, and I'm still on vacation. I have not been able to record a video. I've been to different hotels, and every time I try to go somewhere to do it, I can't. The lobbies or whatever are not okay, and now I'm down by the pool, late night here, probably gonna wake people up, but whatever. I freaking want to do a review. I haven't done one in days. I've watched basically the rest of these. I'm in the middle of six right now, but let's get to four. While I'm here on vacation, though, I'm doing something really awesome for my 1,000 subscribers, which I'm going to hit here in like any second, and I will post it as soon as I do. But anyway, let's get into this Wrong Turn 4 Bloody Beginnings. A lot of people are against the idea of origin movies in the horror genre, especially. And for me, it's just the same I'll say of any film, whether it's found footage or zombie or whatever you think is played out or is unnecessary or whatever. I think that if it's a good movie, it's a good movie. I don't care if it's a this or if it's a that or, you know, oh, we don't need to know Leatherface's origin or Michael Myers or this and that. And it's like, do we need it? No. Do we need 10 fucking more Friday the 13th sequels? No. But I really like a lot of them, you know, and so do a lot of the people who bitch about these origin movies. And it's like, now, granted, if they don't like any origin movies ever, then I can understand where they're coming from, and maybe they should stop watching them, but they don't bother me. Like, I really liked the Texas Chainsaw Massacre, the beginning, you know, the prequel to the remake. I thought that was great. I don't know what everyone's problem with that was. There's been plenty. I really like the Paranormal Activity 2 and 3. Those are really good prequels. I'm a huge fan of the Hobbit trilogy, which I've said a million times. I know everyone hates them, but I think they're wonderful. So prequel things are not a bad thing for me. As I said, good film, then I'm good. Bad film, then I'm bad. Period. So, origin film's fine. We do get to learn that they possess no ability to actually feel anything physically. Their nerves are damaged through inbreeding and they can't feel anything. So that's interesting to know. They can only speak in grunts, but they can speak to each other and seem to be highly intelligent. I think they needed to explain that for the fact that in this movie they're setting like traps, and they set even more grand traps in the fifth one. We're not talking like jigsaw traps here, but enough where it's like inbred hillbillies that you think are basically like mentally retarded. You don't think they'd be able to figure this out. So they kind of explain that. We also find out that Three Finger wasn't born without his fingers. He actually bit them off, which is true of kids that are born with that rare disease or rare thing where they can't feel anything. They always do gnaw their fingers off. I grew up in the 90s with Maury Povich, and I remember those kids that used to bite their fingers off. It was horrible. We get all three of the hillbilly inbreds from the first movie here, their origins. The movie starts in like the 70s. It moves 29 years later. So I don't know how old that's supposed to make them in this. They look like they're teenagers here, so I guess they're in their 40s. Which, I don't know, they're inbred. Three Finger in the first one looked to be younger, but as I said, who knows what their ages are. I have noticed that throughout these films, the makeup just keeps getting worse and worse as they go on. And the opening is actually pretty cool, and my biggest note from this is that the gore in this movie, outside of CGI enhancements, which this one, the next one, and I'm guessing the sixth one will have plenty of, the gore is actually excellent. Like, really, really, like, jaw-dropping at times. Like, oh shit, they just did that? That was gnarly. So, if you're a gore fan, I think that these are a fun series. As far as, like, acting goes, it's hard to be like, well, the acting in this is terrible. It's like, that's to be expected in later Wrong Turn sequels. And I don't feel like the acting in this is horrendous at all times. There's moments where it definitely tips way more into the bad. but for the most part, it's fine, it's whatever. And I really felt like the characters interacted well with each other. I thought that it was realistic enough. Like, I didn't feel like there was a bunch of actors trying to pretend like they're friends. I felt like they were genuinely friends throughout the film. And that sold it enough for me to not just be like, oh my God, this is pure shit. It was fine. There's a decent amount of nudity and sex in this. There's an opening, like, after the initial opening, there's, like, two couples. One's a lesbian couple, and then the other one is a man and a woman. And they're in separate beds, but in the same room, fucking at the same time. And they just kind of keep panning back and forth. And we get a lot of that lesbian sex from that couple in this. They, like, constantly keep going away to have, like, gratuitous nudity and sex, which is never a bad thing. The film also really looks good. I mean, it looks like a higher production value on screen. What the budget was, I can't say, but it does look like a good film, as to where I feel the second one, as I said, I think that movie looks like shit. I know a lot of people say that's better, but honestly, I like this one the best of the sequels so far, 2 and 3 and 5, which I'll get to, but I've watched all of that now, and I can tell you now that that was pretty terrible. Still had some great kills, but we'll get to that for the next review. But call me crazy, I know this is like the most hated one of them all, and I said myself that this is my most hated one, but going back and revisiting it, I wasn't huge on 2, I wasn't crazy about 3, and this one I actually enjoyed. Yes, it's got some stupid shit throughout, but I actually had a good time watching it. And a lot of it was the friendships, the nudity, the gore, stuff like that. The shit I watch these movies for. We have some fake, you know, we have a fake friend scare, which I always point out is something annoying. The generic aspect of it, like the story is, you know, they go into an abandoned asylum and there's killers in there and they all get killed and the end. Like, yes, the story's overplayed and been done a million times and, you know, but that doesn't matter really. I mean, as I said, going back to the Friday the 13th film, the first like 6-7 Friday the 13ths are the exact same damn movie. Especially the first like 3-4. Come on. Like, it's okay that they're generic as long as they're entertaining, and this entertained me enough. I feel like I'm a lawyer right now and I'm defending this film's case because I know a lot of people despise it, and I'll probably get a ton of comments telling me what a moron I am for even enjoying it. But whatever. This, I love also how this place has been abandoned for 29 years and the rednecks seem to be the only ones keeping up it. I don't know if they just like come here. This is like, they're like snowbirds and they like come out here for the winter and then go back. They're like reverse though. They want to be there when the snow is there. But I love how it's like frozen outside and somehow they have fresh produce. They have like onions and shit they're cutting up for the stew. And then inside the hospital, it's been 29 years. No one's been keeping it up. There's no dust on anything. There's no cobwebs. The beds all have like sheets and whatnot. There, everything looks nice and pristine, like the place shut down like a month ago at best. Even then, I feel like it would be worse for wear than it is, especially in snowy climates like it's in. Like, there's harsh weather. It would be, I mean, why do you think Jack Torrance had to come in and keep it going? Like, the place would have fucking fallen apart just with one winter. This is 29 winters with these guys. Have you seen their house in the first one? They don't take very good care of things. It's not like they were maintenancing the place. But, yeah, anyway, doesn't matter. There's some gnarly kills in this. I mean, there's a part where they're skinning a guy, cutting his flesh off and cooking him and eating him in front of him while he's fucking dying. It's gruesome, man. This is a fucking gnarly kill. You don't get to see that a whole ton. It's vicious. It is fucking crazy. So I enjoyed that stuff. It's for a horror fan, I think that this is what it needed to be. The whole idea that these people won't, like, this is where the movie did lose me, though. Enough, I said that I had a good time, but this was the part that pissed me the fuck off, and I can't stand it. Like, these are inbred redneck murderers who have been torturing and killing all your friends, whatever. And when they have them trapped in a cage and they have them like lit up with gasoline and whatnot to be able to kill them, one girl talks the three out of killing them and standing guard. And then of course they end up getting out and killing the guy who's standing guard. So then the girl who was going to let them live decides she wants to come and kill them and ends up stabbing the friend to death. Accidentally thinking it was them. And it's like, really, you just needed one more kill to set it off? Like, these guys, there was no rehabilitation here. This is fucking insane. Kill these people right now. You fucking deserve it at this point, you idiots. I'm sorry, that shit pisses me off. It's like, though, no, not in this case, no. It's too much for me. I can't handle it. I'm screaming at the fucking television. Kill these motherfuckers now. You know this is a prequel, so you know that's not going to happen. But you're like, come fucking on. Really? What do these guys have to do? They have to carve your friend up, cook him and eat him in front of him, and you think there's rehabilitation for all three of them? That you're going to hold them there till the cops get there or something? The fuck out of here. It's shit so stupid. And then one more kill sets you off, that's enough. Like the guy getting cut up, but you having to stab and dealing with your own bullshit, like your own guilt, makes you want to kill them, whatever. And then they end up killing themselves at the end. They're just taking the snowmobile to get the fuck out of there. And, you know, they just run into a thing. I don't think that was put up to kill them. I think it just so randomly happened to be there. Now, the fact that they show up 2 seconds later in their tow truck to get it, maybe they set it up, but the odds, because they like turned into it, because the road was straight ahead. If you actually look at the tracks on the thing, it actually turns around into it and cuts their head off. Why wouldn't they just go up over to the road? So I think it was accidental, but who cares? It's a movie like this, you don't really want to think too much about it. I wish they would have explained how they got their truck. If we're doing an Origins movie, it would have been nice to know where they got a tow truck. If they had a tow truck, then why didn't they leave? And when did they get this cabin? I mean, this is 29 years later. They have to be not far off of part one by this point. And part five just completely ignores the events of part two and three, I'm guessing. Or it's supposed to be set between four and one. Somewhere like in that middle ground of like a semi-prequel, because who knows? I don't know where the timelines are at this point, but whatever. Anyway, as I said, I enjoyed it enough. It's a fun film. I am going to record my review for 5 now, so hopefully this video isn't too dark and you're not like, why the fuck didn't he wait till he gets home? No one gives a shit, but I hope you guys do. So anyway, all right, guys.